Samuel Pierpont Langley became the secretary of the Smithsonian Institution in 1887 and continued to do research in aeronautics the entire time he was head of the Smithsonian. He developed a series of small gasoline and steam-powered aircraft he called aerodromes, which were unpiloted craft. The most successful was the Aerodrome No. 5 and the Aerodrome No. 6, which flew in 1896. By 1903, he had created what he called the Great Aerodrome, or the Aerodrome A, which was his full-size piloted version of his design. Unfortunately, the smaller ones were very structurally weak, and when Langley increased the size of them, he was doomed to failure. Langley developed a large catapult launching system on the top of a houseboat. On October 7th, at Widewater, Virginia, he made his first attempt with this catapult launching of the airplane, and it crashed miserably. A Washington Post reporter quipped that it looked like a handful of mortar falling into the Potomac. On December 8th, 1903, the airplane had been repaired, and this time closer to Washington, D.C., on the Potomac River, the aircraft was put on top of the houseboat again, and another attempt was made, and again, the airplane just simply collapsed upon itself upon launching, and the airplane was never attempted to fly again. The pilot on the Langley Aerodrome was Charles Matthews Manley, Langley's assistant. When the aerodrome crashed for the second time in the icy Potomac on December 8th, 1903, Manley was in the water, and the wreckage of the airplane was on top of him. He had great difficulty extricating himself. By the time he was removed from the aircraft, he was frozen through from the icy water and had to be revived with a little alcoholic spirits. Langley died in 1906, 3 years after his ill-fated attempt to fly his great aerodrome. The airplane was then rebuilt, actually, in 1914 by Glenn Curtis, another aeronautical pioneer who was contracted by the Smithsonian to rebuild the airplane and perform research on it. In 1914, a very heavily modified Langley Aerodrome did make some brief flights, and the airplane was then returned to the Smithsonian Institution, and it was put on public display, and it was characterized as the world's first airplane capable of flight. Well, this, of course, outraged the Wright brothers and started a long feud between the Wright family and the Smithsonian Institution, which finally ended in 1948 upon the death of Orville Wright and the bequeathing of the Wright airplane to the Smithsonian Institution. It was put on public display on December 17, 1948, 45 years to the day after the Wright brothers flew their airplane.